Hi, I'm Gregor Scott, and this is Talkin'Bout Video Games. Nintendo hosted a Nintendo Direct last night, boasting nearly 40 minutes of both new announcements of games and new details on already revealed projects. This Direct in particular is fascinating because of how it has so divided the community watching. In this Direct, Nintendo announced titles across an incredibly broad spectrum, from Kirby to Deadly Premonition, from the Oberdin to Overwatch. If you were to ask any two people who watched the Direct what announcement was most exciting for them, you'd likely get two very different games. And while this may detract from the excitement of one group, it does at least provide something of interest for most people who are watching. One major point that can be brought against the quality of this Direct though is the lack of major announcements. Though to be fair, I myself believe several announcements were spoiled by leaks. Titles such as Overwatch or Doom 64 could have come as a total shock to the majority if it weren't for leaks and mistakes that brought them to our attention well in advance. However, there's no excusing the end stinger, the reveal of the original Xenoblade coming to the Switch. This game is certainly a welcome surprise for many, and had one of my friends whooping and cheering in voice call, but as a final sting to end on, it was pretty lackluster. Think of some of the one more things we've had over the years. Smash Bros., Link's Awakening, a sequel to Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. These are huge games that, whether or not you're a fan of them, you can admittedly say that they're immensely surprising and exciting reveals. The original Xenoblade is certainly a nice surprise, but it's ultimately lackluster in a world of big exciting titles. We have to assume that Nintendo has huge titles in the works, the sorts of things that would blow most people watching away. And yes, while many of these are probably a long way from completion, they still could have used the final moments of this Direct as a platform to produce no end of hype and discussion in the community. And it's not like a game being a long way from completion has stopped Nintendo from revealing games well in advance in the past. Metroid Prime 4 was shown at least 2 years before it was supposed to drop, even if you discount the scrapping and restarting of the project. Breath of the Wild was revealed roughly 4 years before its release. And how close do you really think that aforementioned Breath of the Wild sequel is to launching, especially since we saw nothing of it at this Direct? In general, this Direct seemed to me to be strangely absent of the sort of flair you'd expect from a company like Nintendo. It feels in this moment strangely as if they've run out of steam, as if there's nothing left in the tank for Nintendo and they're struggling to start new projects to tell us about. And while this could very well be the case, I do have a far more likely explanation. All of the games showcased in this Direct had to be showcased at some point. They had to get their time in the spotlight to make sure that people were aware of them. But not a small amount of games either, considering how long this Direct was. My guess is that Nintendo decided that they had enough to show, and that they didn't need to blow the lid off anything new. And this makes sense. Nintendo probably has a decent financial stake in most of the games revealed today, even if they are relatively smaller announcements. And so by not revealing more details on Breath of the Wild 2, or Metroid Prime 4, or a new Mario, or a new Pikmin, Nintendo has forced us as a community to reflect on the games that were presented to us, to analyse them and see what we could enjoy out of that, rather than creating 2-hour breakdowns of frames of a teaser logo reveal that was 10 seconds long. When framed in this way, I actually think that the move Nintendo made was smart. And while we may all be a little disappointed that we didn't get to witness a moment in gaming history, although to be fair, we instead were graced with an ample selection of games to cater to different tastes and styles of play. And really, when we take a step back and think of this in the broader context of Nintendo's history, that's only a good thing. When we look back to days of the Wii U, we remember little to no third-party support, and therefore none of the variety we're blessed with today. This kind of Direct is a testament to the excellence and success of the Switch as a concept. And we can gladly welcome all kinds of weird third-party inclusions because for some of us, those are just the sort of strange games that we want to play on the go. But still, come on Nintendo. Where's Donkey Kong 64 2? Hey, thank you very much for watching. This video has no sponsor, I have no patrons, and I have nothing to sell, but a like and a subscription would mean a lot to me. If you disagree with my stance, or you would like to add something that you think that I missed, the comments below are open for forum and discussion, and I'd love to have a conversation with any of you about what you have to say about this Direct. In the meantime though, take care, brush your hair, and I'll see you when I see you. Peace.